I'm Bridget Bray, I'm Director of Exhibitions here at Asia Society Texas Center, and we're currently featuring an exhibition called Transcendent Deities, The Everyday Occurrence of the Divine, which will be on view until September 14th of this year. And the exhibition is a unique opportunity to see the work associated with three artists, one from the modern period, Raja Ravi Varma, who's represented by a number of prints in the exhibition, the photographer Manjari Sharma, and the artist Abhishek Singh. The two latter artists are both living and work between India and New York. The exhibition is a chance for visitors to connect with what's happening in the modern and contemporary period associated with Hindu gods and goddesses. Many of us associate it with earlier classical material, sculptures and paintings that you might see in temple settings. So this is a great way to understand how those traditions carry forward and how they're continuing to inspire artists today. So the first artist that's featured in the exhibition, Raja Ravi Varma, was trained as an oil painter in the European academic style. And what we are representing in the exhibition is a body of prints that were made on a press founded in his name. He played a very important role in democratizing and promulgating images of Indian gods and goddesses to the general public. At that time, at the end of the 19th century, these are images that you might have only seen in a temple setting or in aristocratic homes. So by virtue of the multiples that you could produce off of a press, it made it much more accessible to the general public. And as a result, for anyone who traveled or lived in India in the later 20th century, these images will be very familiar. They're very unique because each one of the prints, in most cases, has been decorated with either silk or other embellishments that show a veneration of the object, as well as a desire to further beautify the surface of the work. So in the prints, as well as some of the other works in the exhibition, you'll begin to become familiar with certain deities. If you've already lived or worked or traveled in India, they're very familiar to you already. If you don't know anything, that's fine because you'll learn by the end of the exhibition. But you'll expect to see someone like Vishnu or Brahma or Shiva or goddesses such as Lakshmi and Parvati. And then you begin to understand the role they play in the practice of the Hindu religion and how they might form a relationship with the worshiper. And so it's very important for us also is to draw attention to the role of the observer or the viewer in the exhibition. There's a Sanskrit term, darshan, which means to view or be viewed by. And so that's a very important concept for people who are less familiar with these religious practices, is to understand that there's a sense of seeing the image and having the image look back at you. And so that's why many of the prints that you'll see in the Raja Ravi Varma area have a direct or frontal pose with a direct gaze. It's the idea that you can set up an open channel of communication between the viewer and that which is being viewed. So we're pleased to feature as a second artist in the exhibition, Manjari Sharma, and she's a photographer that was born and raised in India and is currently working in Brooklyn in New York. We're pleased to be able to share these images because it's a series of nine and we have all nine represented in the exhibition. They're large format photographs, but they're uniquely framed and they feature hand-hammered repoussé brass frames, which very much give a sense of a temple space. And then of course the photographs feature the deities themselves. I think that Manjari is very unique because she is innovating through tradition. She isn't a contemporary artist that feels that they need to abandon tradition to practice their own work or express their conceptual concerns. She actually uses this rich millennia-long tradition that she can draw from in India, you know, truly a cradle of civilization, to do very cutting-edge contemporary work in the 21st century. I think Manjari's process is fascinating because when we think of a photographer, we think of it as a solo exercise or a solitary concern. In some ways, because the production of these images is so involved, it's probably even more accurate to think of her almost in terms of a film director. She's casting the appropriate model, she's working with scenic artists, costume artists, jewelers, other designers, really bringing a team together, sometimes as many as 3 dozen people, to make that one image come together in the way that she's visualized. And so I think that that's really interesting, is the way she works. We're also pleased in the exhibition to be able to feature process videos, the making of, if you will, videos of her photographs. And I think that's a really important chance for visitors to kind of understand and unpack her process. Some of the models that she selected for the photographs, such as the man who embodies Brahma in the photograph, he himself is an architect. And so there's a very fitting resonance there between Brahma as the creator of worlds and the man who is an architect who is embodying him in that photograph. Also in the Lakshmi image, there's been a conversation between her and the model that it actually ended up being quite fortunate for her to portray Lakshmi in that photograph. Great things have come to her since then, such as being the recipient of the Miss India Award. So Manjari definitely has a great eye, not just for the photographic work she does, but the people she chooses to work with. We're very excited to be able to feature Abhishek Singh in the exhibition. This is his first time that most audiences in Houston and Texas will have seen his work. He originally trained as a graphic design, illustration, that kind of work, and then formed a relationship with some designers that were creating comic books or graphic novels looking back at the Indian epics such as the Mahabharata or the Ramayana. So he was part of that unique work, very interesting early 21st century work. And he's parlayed that into an entire series and body of work, some of which we're featuring in the exhibition, that shows his deep philosophical concerns. He is somebody who goes back and reads the epics and really muses on the content and the visual imagery they suggest to therefore inform his own work. And I think it's important for people to understand that these rich visual narratives are not necessarily something that's just in the past. They carry forward, they're active today, they're meaningful today, they can impact our lives today. And by looking at the way they impact the work of these three artists, I think we can really connect to that reality.